Greetings, unsettled souls!
Go!
Welcome to The Correct Views. Sam I. Di Gangi doing political commentary for the media speaks. I also am with the conservative Daily Post, Blasting News, and the event Passing Time. With the massive Fukushima update. Now, Christelle had mentioned that the last show that was an error. We did not miss April Fool's Day. Is that official?
That is, yeah, that is pretty official, seeing how it is March, and March does come before April.
So it was actually the Friday the 13th that we missed to do the show correction from the last one. Moving on here, a Fukushima update, full blown friends, do me a favor, make sure you share it, make sure you hit subscribe. This is usually the biggest show that we do throughout the month. So I think it's important to make sure that everyone knows that everything is sourced here. Because a lot of the things you're going to hear, you're going to not want to believe because they're so dreadful. But you're going to go ahead and want to pay attention. Because all of it's sourced, all of it's true, and all of it's happening right now. As a result of, I was going to say bad nuclear power placement, but a better way to put it would be due to any nuclear power placement. It's grim. I'm not happy to report it. How many of you know that they've been losing robots like pennies in Fukushima every time they go to send one in? It doesn't come back out again. Check this out. TheVerge.com, another robot has died in the depths of one of Fukushima's nuclear reactors as attempts to locate and remove the melted radioactive fuel continue. This is the second robot in 2 weeks to meet its end in the Fukushima Daiichi nuclear power plant, the site of a major nuclear accident caused by the devastating 2011 earthquake and tsunami. Now remember that I just covered this at the Conservative Daily Post. If you go there, you'll find that I've written a number of articles on it. Just search Conservative Daily Post Fukushima. And I've covered the robots and the reactor meltdowns. And this is another one. This is not a rehash of the existing information. The robot's mission, it says, was to investigate the pedestal underneath the Unit 2 reactor, where melted fuel is suspected to have fallen. But about 10 feet away from its target, one of the robot's tank-like treaders got stuck. World Nuclear News reports Tokyo Electric Power Company, that's TEPCO, that's GE, where you do not want to invest, not even in mutual funds, pull your money out. It operates the plant, and they decided to cut the robot's cable and abandon it inside the reactor. The TEPCO spokeswoman told fizz.org that they don't know yet whether radiation or debris stopped the robot. So far, on every other one, we know that it's been the radiation, for the most part. And if it does get hung up on debris, it's as good as dead from the radiation. We also know that. It says the Unit 2 primary containment investigation at Fukushima D, the Scorpion robot, obtained additional information from Unit 2 PCV on February 16th. The Scorpion-shaped robot was inserted into the Unit 2 primary containment vessel at Fukushima. That's where it's supposed to keep all the radiation from getting to you and I. And they wanted to investigate the condition within. It went along the CRD rail and led to the area directly below the reactor pressure vessel called the pedestal area and obtained additional information such as the PCB interior, deposits, conditions, temperature readings, and radiation levels. Even though the robot could not reach the pedestal area, which we had initially planned to investigate, valuable information was obtained which will help us determine the methods to eventually remove the fuel rods. How many of you know that eventually means within like 25 to 35 years or longer? We don't even know how to get close to the reactor much yet. We don't even know if all the fuel, we know for sure all of it isn't. We don't even know how much of the fuel is in it. Okay, things are really that bad. They don't even have the technology to make something. They've been cutting corners with money, but even if they had the technology, the money, they don't have the technology. We don't have any way to get near this. It's like approaching a sun. That's the option over the original plan was since it stopped over the deposits. TEPCO Holdings will continue to review the information. Yeah, I'm sure they will. And they'll continue to try to cover up for it. 2 feet long and shaped like a scorpion, this robot is equipped with a camera on its front and another camera on its tail that can whip up and down and around. It also reports temperature and radiation sensors to SHIBA and the International Research Institute for Nuclear Decommissioning, designed the scorpion robots to scoot on caterpillar treads like a tank through pipes about 4 inches wide, and it's now at least the 7th robot to have broken down while investigating the nuclear reactors. That's how radioactive it is. What do you think it's doing to your cells if it's doing this to machines? Reuters had counted up to 5 by March of 2016. Last week, a scouting robot was sent in. We covered that ahead to clear way for the Scorpion robot. And it was pulled back about 2 hours. The camera had been fried by high radiation levels, estimated to be 650 sieverts an hour. For scale, a CAT scan exposes you to 0.0006 sieverts. And just half a sievert is enough to cause radiation sickness. Half a sievert? And we're talking about 650 per hour. We're talking about literally being inside of a microwave oven. And it's another setback for TEPCO, which has still not succeeded at removing the molten radioactive fuel from 3 of the 4 reactors that need decommissioned. Yeah, and they're not going to be able to either, because it's so hot they can't get anywhere near it. New radiation level at Fukushima dwarfed the highest peak at Chernobyl. This is from Zero Hedge. I've grown very tired of hearing people refer to Chernobyl as the worst accident in worst radioactive disaster in history. Not only is that not true, not only is Fukushima much worse, but Fukushima is so bad as to be the single worst disaster in all of recorded history. And this, of course, has been confirmed by doctors. Chris Busby is one of them. This has the potential to be a life extinction event. And everyone thinks that because it's not being reported on, that it's somehow less than that, that it's not as important as that, that you can go ahead and keep eating mushrooms and drinking milk like you always did, because nothing is going to happen to you. Something will happen to you if you continue with this. Particularly if you are prone to living on the West Coast in areas in California where they're toxic. There's a waiting list to be cremated. So many people are dying in California, and the death spike directly correlates to the Fukushima disaster. And that can be looked up. That can be measured and proven very easily. Zero Hedge, the Fukushima disaster, we noted a few days ago after the Japanese earthquake that the amount of radioactive fuel at Fukushima dwarfed that at Chernobyl, and that the cesium fallout from Fukushima already rivaled Chernobyl. But we also noted that the radiation could end up on the west coast of North America, which it has. The next month, we pointed out that TEPCO admitted that the radiation from Fukushima could exceed that from Chernobyl, and that Fukushima's reactors actually had suffered something worse than a total meltdown. New nuclear melt-throughs, where the nuclear fuel melted through the containment vessel and into the ground. Of course, that means into the water and into what we all consume, and are washing into the ocean. So when you eat seafood like an idiot, yeah, you're going to end up poisoned from it. A few months later, it says, we reported that radiation will pollute the area around Chernobyl for 5 to 10 times longer than models predicted, between 180 to 320 years. It's going to be a lot longer than that. We're talking about millions and, in some instances, billions of years for the half-life of things like uranium, which is basically, for all intents and purposes, forever. Fukushima's reactors had, at least from our point of view, actually suffered something much worse than a total meltdown. We know that. The following year, they pointed out that the operator of the Fukushima plant admitted that they couldn't find the melted fuel from reactor number 2, and that the technology doesn't even exist to clean it up. Now, the highest radiation level at Fukushima dwarfs Chernobyl, 300 sieverts per hour was at Chernobyl, an incomprehensibly high dose which can kill a man instantly. To put it in perspective, radiation is usually measured around a thousandth of a sievert, called millisieverts. For example, most people receive around 2.4 millisieverts per year from background radiation, or only about 0.00027397 26 per hour. Very, very low. The radiation level at 530 sieverts per hour has just been measured at Fukushima. Now keep in mind, the highest was 300 sieverts at Chernobyl. This is 530. The new record at Fukushima is 70% higher than that at Chernobyl. The highest level previously measured at Fukushima was 73 sieverts, and that was only on March of 2012. There's a bunch of links for at least 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, there are like 15 links there from Zero Hedge about where you can source the ongoing problem that has been there for those of you that have not kept up on this since day one. Or better yet, just go to my channel and keep going back. I do them all the time. It's Correct Views, Fukushima. Japan Times, we're not even near done. Financial crunch time looms for Fukushima's voluntary evacuees. In other words, I'm not sure which this is here. I'm not sure if they used... I mean, they've had since 2012 to get their life in order and to find another place. I don't know why they're still in evacuee centers. Maybe they're waiting for the lawsuit to come through from Fukushima that destroyed their homes. I don't know. But I don't know why they're still there. If they were given money, I don't know why they... Or if they used it on something else. I have no idea. But they're running out of money to give the evacuees, which, I mean, it was 2012 that this, 2011, excuse me, that this happened. So, I mean, at some point you do have to move on. You can't keep living in the evacuee center, but still, they're going to end up moving back home is what they're going to be doing, and that's going to be a disaster. This month, housing subsidies ran out for those who fled the Fukushima nuclear disaster from areas that the government designated the evacuation zone, and the clock ticks down. Evacuees have to decide whether to return or move once again. Well, why would you move to the evacuation center and then decide that you were going to plop there forever? I don't get it. Many of these so-called voluntary evacuees are mothers seeking to avoid risking their children's health while their husbands remain in radiation-hit Fukushima Prefecture. Well, get your husband out of Fukushima Prefecture, because there's no way to clean the area. There's no way to make it safe for future generations. There's nothing you can do to make it any better. All you're doing is sending your kid, sending your husband off so he can leave you and your child without a father, unfortunately. This is why the term voluntary evacuee is misleading, as it gives the impression that they fled Fukushima for selfish reasons. Yoshida told the news conference in January in Tokyo. He's a freelance journalist, Chia Yoshida. The Fukushima Prefecture government has been paying the cost of public and private housing for voluntary evacuees under the Disaster Relief Act. And that's been going on since the Fukushima number one reactor plant after the earthquake, of course. The same news conference described them as a domestic refugee. The number of evacuees from the disaster, including those from mandatory evacuation areas, peaked at 164,865 in May of 2012. This year, 11,321 of the 12,239 voluntary evacuee households had already decided where to live after April. 250 had not. The actual government's evacuation orders have been lifted, and the difficult-to-return zones. They're trying to con people into moving into areas to where it's going to be detrimental to their health. And of course, if they die, then they just don't have to be paid for anymore. The no-entry areas are subject to radiation of over 50 millisieverts per year, compared to the government's long-term target of less than one. And that's after decontamination work. Rika Mashida, 46, is a voluntary evacuee living in Tokyo. She had decided to rent a house near a Fukushima-paid apartment where she and her daughter, now in elementary school, are currently living so that her daughter does not miss her friends. These people just don't get it.
They just don't get it. I don't want her to miss her friends, so I'm going to let her get cancer. Yeah, the worst Mother of the Year award goes to Mrs. Amashiko. What a freaking idiot. What an absolute dolt. Just ignore the radiation. And then went, my kid, to feel. Everything is feelings. How do you feel? I feel like you're an idiot. I also know it, you dolt. The free housing has been a lifetime for many of the kids there, particularly the younger ones. Then there's another individual here, Yamana, 75. Says poor understanding of the plight of voluntary evacuees has played a role in bullying cases involving evacuee children that have been reported across Japan since last year. They need, quite likely, to get out of Japan, at least to move to the east of the country if you must stay. Because of the direction of the jet stream. The first financial support from Yamada's fund went to 10 mothers and their children in January 15th. He was surprised to see the recipients shed tears of joy upon receiving 200,000 to 300,000 yen each. The government has tried to reduce the number of evacuees from Fukushima in order to claim that their ranks have decreased and that disaster has been overcome. Disaster would never be overcome, unfortunately, but there are things that you can do to make life a little easier for yourself. Not supporting General Electric helps us all. Vitamin C around 3,000 milligrams. Calcium levels intact. Men, be careful. Echinacea for one. But again, it's everywhere. You could be postponing the inevitable. And the reason that I'm talking about this, and the reason that it matters so much, I write about it, is you can make sure that these things are diminished in the future by not being foolish enough to subscribe to the notion that anything nuclear can lead to anything but disaster. Once that is known, once that is factored in, then the obvious correct answer is the only one that's left, which is to not use anything nuclear. And if you teach enough people this, you'll always have people that will insist that there is more than one way to do something. But in many instances, there's not. There's no way to reword opening a nuclear power plant. It's going to make it any less of a dumb idea. You're just going to sound dumber every time you stick by the idea. So you're dumber the fourth time than you were the first, because you've already been proven wrong three times. No, you can't do it. You absolutely can't do it. Friends, this is brought to you here by Sticker Junkie. What caused the mysterious radioactive plume in Europe? Moving on to how this affects us on a national level. Thank you, Sticker Junkie, where you check out line, type in correct use, you're going to get a discount. For a while, we still think it was very likely Putin testing nuclear weapons in the Arctic. And if it's true, in the Great North, I should say, if it's true, then what he's done is an act of war. There are levels of radiation that are not safe. Don't let them tell you they are. That are washing all over the EU and Britain and other places, because it's coming down from the north, assimilating into the jet stream and poisoning the entire EU, which I wouldn't put past something that Putin could possibly do on purpose. I could see where that could happen. I don't really trust the man. That's also why I'm happy that it's being proven that Trump had nothing to do with him, because I don't think he's a very good person. there's a lot of speculation, but authorities still don't know what the source of the mysterious cloud of radioactive iodine, that is a deadly, deadly cancer agent, will hit the thyroid and create problems for a lifetime. Iodine-131 has swept across Europe in recent weeks. It is believed the radioactivity came from Eastern Europe, but not much else is known. The U.S. Air Force sent out the WC-135, they're called sniffer jets, Constant Phoenix, nuclear sniffer plane, there it does say it, to collect radioactive debris, cloud samples, and try to find evidence of a nuclear explosion, as the mainstream media is floating the idea that Russia may have tested a nuclear warhead somewhere in the Arctic. The Comprehensive Nuclear Test Ban Treaty, which I'm sure he would be happily break, has ruled out the possibility that such a test took place. So that's good. So far, no explanation has been found for the radiation burst. Authorities first detected the cloud in Norway in mid-January, and it has since been detected in ground-level atmosphere in Finland, Poland, Czech Republic, Germany, France, and Spain. Despite detecting the cloud a month ago, the public was not informed until recently. Now, you'll notice that. Despite detecting the cloud a month ago, the public was not warned until recently. This is for everyone that thinks that the authorities are going to be there if a nuclear disaster happens, because you've just seen that it didn't. They're going to roll it a safe while you're getting juiced, while you're getting the building blocks of a future cancer. They are going to go ahead and downplay it. Just like they say that your money is safe in the banks, and it isn't. And they're going to take it the first time they need to. The first time they need to lie to you about a nuclear issue, one that jeopardizes you and your family's health, your heart, your cancer rates, and your overall quality of life. Remember this sentence: despite detecting the cloud a month ago, the public was not informed until recently. So they couldn't get potassium iodide. Potassium iodide will protect you from most of the problems inherent in iodine-131 by refusing to allow the iodine to mimic the iodine-131 cannot enter the body. If the body will not accept it if it's already full of the proper iodine, which could have been done if they had been told about it. Instead, the absolutely toxic iodine-131 is now in everyone's body because they didn't know to prepare for it, because the government didn't tell them. Iodine-131 has a short life, just 8 days. It's typically found alongside other radioactive isotopes. Supposedly, in this case, it wasn't, which authorities find bizarre. Although iodine-131 can contaminate food and water and cause all kinds of health issues, including thyroid cancer, just like with everything else, authorities continue to stress that there is no health concerns with this plume. Begging the question, if it's no big deal, why did they wait so long after they detected the radiation to alert the public? Why also did they not warn people in time that they could have protected themselves from at least part of the problem? Could it be that they caused it themselves, and that they don't want lawsuits by admitting that they created the problem, so they're trying to hide it for as long as they can? Could it be a dirty bomb? I don't think a dirty bomb could just give off iodine-131, but it would have to be asked. Two more to get to, friends. Don't go away. Iran says shipment will boost its supply of uranium, because we all know that nothing is better than building a nuclear power plant on an earthquake zone, so that the resulting fallout can kill more Arabs than every Jew in Israel if they were given free rein to do so. Iran's nuclear chief says it will have 60% more stockpiled uranium than it did prior to the landmark 2015 agreement with world powers, after a shipment expected later this week. It's dated the 6th, just 2 days ago. Ali Akbar Shalai was quoted, who's trying to blow up Iran with a power plant, by the semi-official Fars news agency on Sunday as saying that Iran will receive the final batch of 149 tons of natural uranium by Tuesday, in addition to 210 tons already received since 2016. Under the nuclear accord, Iran's import of uranium is supervised by the International Atomic Energy Agency, who, of course, we all know will hide any nuclear disaster that does happen, so we'll all be safe. Low-enriched uranium can be used for civilian applications, including power generation and medical research. Highly enriched uranium can be used for nuclear weapons. Iran agreed to curb enrichment and place its nuclear program under international surveillance in exchange for lifting sanctions. Now, I've covered this repeatedly at the Conservative Daily Post. We know without a doubt that Iran has already broken this agreement a number of times. They have enriched uranium, they have been caught funding terrorism, and basically, at this point, since we don't want anybody to be poisoned, and we know that they're going to, we know this because they're building on an earthquake zone where people that were right told them that it was, and somebody else wanted to tell them that there must have been more than one way to do it, so they built a nuclear power plant there, and they're going to melt it down. We know this because the seismic activity that we're seeing in that earthquake zone matches the exact same seismic activity that we had seen before Fukushima. But it gets better because we're not just basing it on Fukushima, but we're basing it on the fact that Fukushima was predicted, as we build on the shoulders of giants, they say, upon earthquake data that we have known for a very long time. We know how to tell when earthquake seasons are going to happen, and those are whole sections of decades they could be. And we know when that's going to occur, and we know that it's going to occur in Iran. So at this point, since so many people in Iran love to chant death to America, death to Jews, death to Israel, death to non-Sharia, let's hope that if anybody has to be Jews, we don't want them to be, then let's hope it's the people that have been supporting this. Let's hope it's the people that were chanting death to America, because I don't even want to see them on a cancer bed. But if it has to happen to anyone, it couldn't have happened to more deserving people than the people that are praising this being brought in, particularly those that know better. Some do not. And again, the hope is that nobody gets it, because I don't want it to. That's such a bad death, I wouldn't wish it on anyone. But they're literally signing themselves up for it, friends. And that brings us to the DUMBDEE of the day! Yes, Fukushima does have a DUMBDEE of the day, too. And no surprise to anybody. Who is the idiot? Well, kind of the universal idiot. My favorite world nutcase, Kim Jong-un. North Korean diplomat warns of major escalation that might turn into actual war. Now, this is only dangerous because North Korea has the ability to sucker in China and potentially Russia against us in the event that they do something stupid like escalate this war. Hence the DUMBDEE of the day. But they themselves have maybe one, two nuclear warheads. History has shown us that a third of them roughly won't make it. They'll probably land on their own country and may or may not detonate there, which would be a mess for South Korea and the innocents stranded there. But beyond that, far removed from that, is the fact that America would likely ping these out of the sky before they got to Hawaii. Things like THAAD and the Patriot missile technology and things that we likely don't know about are in existence to remove the threat of nuclear war by eliminating the ability of them to reach their targets. But do you know, I've written this before, do you know what would happen if you attempted a nuclear missile strike on the United States of America? Do you have any idea how that would go? America then would be, well, first of all, whether we all blow each other up or not, Kim Jong-un would be removed from North Korea, whether China liked it, and we would tell Putin where to put that bottle of vodka, how many different ways to twist it, and whether or not he can drink it when it's done. Because we would be moving Kim Jong-un out of North Korea, which again, I'm not for nation building, but if you launch a nuclear weapon on us, then the non-violence agreement, of which most of us libertarians like, will be out the window at that point. This is a no-win for him. Listen to this. Yesterday's snap deployment of the U.S. THAAD anti-missile system in South Korea, which wouldn't be there if North Korea wasn't building nuclear weapons and threatening the United States, then we wouldn't have put these on South Korea's land. This is because of North Korea, so they cannot blame us for doing it. The lovely Christelle loves to ask why something happens. Put it this way, someone will say, why in the world did you do this? Not understanding or not wanting to understand that you did it because of something else that was done before it. North Korea is causing the problems that lead to the government putting THAAD systems, anti-missile systems, on South Korea's land, and then blaming America for putting THAAD missiles on South Korea's land to escalate the problem. Do you see the wordplay there? Well, this has led to significant reverberations among the region, with not only North Korea, but also Russia and China slamming the move. So they are losing their allies, thankfully.
As reported last night, various equipment, including two launch pads for U.S. missile defense systems known as THAAD, arrived in South Korea. It happened on Monday. And they will continue to be brought in, Yonhap News said. Continued provocative actions by North Korea, to include yesterday's launch of multiple missiles, only confirmed the prudence of our alliance decision last year to deploy THAAD to South Korea. And this is from Admiral Harry Harris. Harry Harris? Commander of the U.S. Pacific Command. He said in a news release. Is that like Dave Davidson from the Bates Motel? Mr. Dave Davidson. This doesn't make any sense. I've got all kinds of viewers down there. Leave me comments in the stream. Does this make any sense to any of you? North Korea has basically delivered them to their own doorstep by their own actions. U.S. Secretary of Defense James Mad Dog Mattis and South Korean Defense Minister Han Min-kwoo spoke over the phone last week and agreed THAAD should be deployed ASAP. What is it with many of the Asian nations? You always hear how conceited and how arrogant the United States is. The people in the West. Well, China believes that they have the divine right to not only tell their people what they will do, but to tell the rest of the world in turn what we will do. Then you'd say, okay, that's just China. Well, Japan has told the entire world that they will not accept help for Fukushima, and it had to be forced upon them. And you could say that they're a sovereign nation, but that doesn't really apply when you're reducing other countries. It is now not a sovereign nation issue. It's the analogy I use of your duplex neighbor having a meth lab. That would not be something you were okay with. Now you've got North Korea thinking everybody else has to do what they're to accept what they're doing when it's threatening those around them. What is it with Asian countries that so often insist that they be put in situations that jeopardize other people that they be allowed to do it? We saw it even in Vietnam back in the day. It is not just an issue of the West, my friends. These are Asian countries we're talking about that are like this. White House Press Secretary Sean Spicer signaled the deployment Monday when he told reporters that the U.S. is taking steps to enhance our ability to defend against North Korea's ballistic missiles, such as the deployment of THAAD batteries in South Korea. Well, good. Because Kim Jong-un can't send missiles into the sky, he can't be expected to provoke us and tell us that he is going to bomb us, that he's going to bring us down, and that we're not going to do anything about it. He's the dumbass that got us to look his way, and now he's wondering why we're looking his way. Dumbdee of the day. We've left him alone for how many decades? Anybody else would have been overthrown years ago. The world's just been too busy to deal with him as he starves his own people and puts them in concentration camps that make Nazi Germany look like Disneyland. China and Russia log protest against the deployment. We think U.S. South Korean decision to deploy THAAD missile defense systems was seriously threatened China's security interests. Well, then maybe China should have done a little bit more to have brought their stray dog inward. That would be North Korea. Deployment of U.S. missile defense systems in South Korea clearly goes beyond the tasks of deterring the North Korean threat. You wouldn't think so if you were South Korea or if you were any of the other Asian countries that are trusting the United States to prevent them from being destroyed by a madman that you lost control of. It's your Frankenstein monster, dumbasses. However, it was North Korea which was expected the most vocal and tried to shift the blame away from its recent launch of the four ballistic missiles and redirect attention to the joint U.S.-South Korean drills taking place. North Korea, according to Reuters, faced a chorus of condemnation on Tuesdays for its latest ballistic missile test. Ju Yong-shoi, the North Korean diplomat, told the UN-sponsored conference on disarmament in Geneva that the massive, unprecedented joint drills were a major cause of escalation and tension that might cause might turn into an actual war. They're not going to do very well in that one. I'm not really sure they could beat, I don't know. Somalia. I don't think it can beat anybody. Robert Wood, a U.S. disarmament ambassador, reported that South Korea was a pariah, an outlier, and violated multiple U.N. security codes. They don't really care about the U.N. And not that they should. I mean, in that instance, who cares?
I don't even want America in the UN, but I certainly don't want a rogue nation testing nuclear weapons and threatening other countries either. The U.S. is now ready for to fire anti-missile weapons at moment's notice at, out of North Korea, and many are concerned the Lex launched by North Korea's irrational war may promptly escalate and bring the region into a state of conventional war. I do think that if he launches test missiles again, it might not be a bad idea for President Trump to knock them out of the sky. Particularly if they leave North Korean airspace, which they've been doing. They've been landing in the Sea of Japan, actually washing along economic shipping lanes in Japan. So, if they... Yeah, this sovereign nation status, I get it. If it leaves the North Korean airspace, I think Trump probably shouldn't shoot the rocket down. But, again, that could be a slippery slope, so he may want to contact Russia and Putin first. China and Putin first, which he could do if the media would let him do his damn job! Friends, you're listening to The Correct Views, another successful show. Do me a favor, hit share, hit subscribe, and thank you for watching. I've been on here now for a minute. Share this everywhere because these are the shows that do best. And please remember that I am listener supported. That means when you donate to me at thecorrectviews@hotmail.com, all the money goes towards a better show. Thank you, friends. Good night. God bless.